Hello everyone, we are at the German Panzer Museum and this is the director Ralf Ratz.
Hello.
And today we'll take a short look at the question, why Hetzer? Because many argue it's not the real name, it's the wrong name and something else, but it's quite complicated. I mean, it's a German thing.
Yeah, basically it's not quite complicated, but it's interesting because what makes the question exist at all is the lack of sources. So we can't throw sources at each other, and so it's not that complicated, but the name is in the room. Everybody calls this vehicle Hetzer. By the way, this one is a retrofitted G13 from the Swiss Army, so we're talking about this vehicle as a Hetzer, as a stand-in, so for full disclosure. But anyways, we're talking now about the Hetzer name. And for all those English-speaking people out there who don't know what a Hetzer is, we have to explain it, I think. It's a hunting term. If you hunt down an animal, in German, you hetz it. You follow it until it breaks down. That's hetzen. I think the
name that's pushing in a way colloquially. Don't hetze mich nicht.
That means don't make me go faster than I can. That's basically it. Yeah. Because the dog tries to make the game run faster than the cans until it breaks down. And so now we have these stickers on our cars, right? So hetzen is actually a pretty aggressive term.
Yeah.
And as we told the audience earlier, the tank destroyers weren't aggressive, basically. They were waiting and firing from ambush situations. So Hetzer is a nice name. It's a name that rings emotionally for Germans because they know the term, but it seems to be very liked in the whole world because the Hetzer sounds cool. It has a nice tone to it, obviously.
And I think I probably even more German than Panzer, probably, with the T-set and everything.
Yeah, maybe, yeah. The writing looks interesting.
And
yeah.
I think they can easily pronounce it as well, probably.
Hetzer,
because yeah. I think Hetzer is gonna Hetzer. I never heard this in a wrong way. Whereas Panzer, you rarely
hear. Panzer, yeah, you're right. Panzer, yeah. Hetzer, yeah. Everybody, yeah, it's nice. So obviously the name is approachable and usable. So that might be a factor why it's so well known today. So. And the Hetzer, yeah, that's a good point. Maybe because of this, it's now a pop cultural thing. Because in World of Tanks and from then on in other games and internet forums and so on, the Hetzer is a household name. Everybody knows it. At least everybody knows what silhouette is meant with it, even if they don't know the details. So the big question is, was it an original name in the time? And it seems to be that it was not. The first question has to be, so why did it come later if it wasn't? The other part we will do in a minute. And I think that's the reason, because if the people sat down later and wrote their memoirs and their novels and everything like that, the Hetzer, the name was a thing that fitted very well in a good book or good story. You could easily talk about it and it was, that's interesting, the Hetzer. So I think that's the reason why it survived from the roughly 50s to today until it reached internet fame. So what's the root of it? Where does it come from? And there are just speculations about it. We have to be honest. And there's a plausible speculation. I like this term. There's a plausible speculation that it's based on a misunderstanding. When the German delegation traveled to Bohemia to discuss with the Bohemian engineers how the Jagdpanzer 38T, the official designation of this vehicle, would be built and how it could turn out, they also talked about the famous E-series, the E-tanks. And in this collection of E-tanks, which were only designed or planned on paper mostly, was the E-10, a very small and very agile and very quick vehicle. Tank destroyer again, but for its time, very mobile. So there the name Hetzer would have really fit. So it's argued that the idea of the Hetzer was pinpointed to the E-10, but based on a misunderstanding in the conference of the engineers, the Bohemians took the name and pointed it to the Jagdpanzer 38T. So that would be the first point where the name Hetzer occurred in some papers for some reason. The Germans were very fond of these suggestive names, so it made sense for them to say, okay, the Germans want this to be called Hetzer. On the other hand, if you think hardly about this is not a very mobile vehicle.
Yeah.
It doesn't hetz anything. It's very typical for its time. It's not very quick, and additionally, as said, it's hiding and firing from a hidden position. So, at this point, Hetzer is somehow mentioned in the papers, and people know that it could/should/would be called Hetzer, maybe. So it's in the world. The next source evidence that people in the Wehrmacht, the soldiers, actually called it Hetzer are very thin. I just know of one document where it's actually Panzerjägerabteilung wrote, we received 28 Hetzers, or Hetzer, plural in German. That's the only source I know. Maybe the brain of the internet knows more, but at this point I just know one. Even if there would be 10 or 20 sources, we're talking about millions of soldiers using hundreds of these vehicles, yeah. Or thousands, nearly 3,000. So obviously the name was not used often, not nearly often. There is one instance where Guderian made a report to Hitler, and in the notes, there's written, the soldiers call it Hetzer. The name obviously came from the soldiers upwards, so a grassroots name, which is obviously wrong because, as we know, the Bohemians had it in their papers that this should be a Hetzer, so it doesn't come from the soldiers. So this route is wrong, obviously. The other one shows it's very thin. So that's very interesting. Obviously, the name is based on a misunderstanding. Then there's a thin line how it traveled through the war on some papers. And then after the war, the name was so attractive in the novels and the memoirs that it, yeah, survived decades. And now it's an internet star. But
I might have something to add. This is from memory. I'm not entirely sure. I discussed this with Nicolas Morin, the chieftain. And I think he referred to the Bond document. And he suggested that it might have been used with Hetzer, that it was a... more a name for the whole class of Jagdpanzers, probably.
Oh.
So that they not specifically meant one vehicle, but maybe...
Which source do you mean, the Panzerjägerabteilung or...?
I don't know. I think he referred to something, because I heard something, I think that Zaloga posted something. Yeah. I think Craig Moore told me that at Tankfest. Then yeah. At Corneo, I think I asked...
That's how we work, people. That's how we work.
and he said there's this... theory or thesis, yeah. Something, and this is all from memories. This could be terribly wrong, what I'm telling you right now.
Basically, Nicholas is guilty.
I think Craig Moore told me that Zaloga posted something, and then I asked Chifton about it, yeah. And he said it could be that it was referring to the whole class of vehicles. But I'm not sure if it refers to that document that, yeah. You know.
Yeah. So, my first impulse would be, to be honest, Nicholas, I really like you, but it seems far-fetched. Because it applies the name to an even bigger thing, which again implies it should have been even in more wide use.
Because the name, yeah, I mean, this is the other thing. I mean, Jagdpanzer, for Jagdpanzer, generally use Hetzer would make sense, actually.
Yeah, but for that, the evidence is even thinner, I think.
Yeah.
So, and it would be a really big step to change or give a complete class of vehicles a new suggestive name. And
but that could be, they could be coming up from the soldiers, maybe.
Wow. So that yeah, possible, but I'd like to know more about that source-wise. As I said, it's all very, very, very misty and very, very, very foggy. So it could be. I mean, never would deny it, but it seems far-fetched.
We should generally add here, if you look at Jens and Doyle in the Panzertrack series, they usually list all the names they found in the documents for each vehicle, and it's like, I think, you have like 8, sometimes 13, sometimes 14. I mean, also with this one.
The official designations.
This had Jagdpanzer 38T. Yeah. I think it had leichter Jagdpanzer.
Yeah, and Jagdpanzer 38T leicht, used also.
Okay, and then they dropped the T.
Yes.
Then they dropped the T. and then there's also the D variant for the diesel.
Yeah, right.
And I think so it's like... Yeah, it really depends on which time point and which official document you use, because internally and then finally officially, then I think there was one update in the Nachrichtenblatt der Panzertruppe at one point that I think denoted the Leicht was dropped or something.
Yeah, so that's basically it. Very interesting.
It can be complicated. I think it's complicated sometimes. Sometimes it's more easy, yeah. Mm.
But it's very interesting
that
this name survived decades and we don't know where it comes from and how it was used. I mean, we're not talking about medieval times here.
I mean, the interesting point you made in the beginning, that's from 1950s around. Mm. And from my general encounter with all the myths so far about the Wehrmacht in the Second World War, is basically nearly everything dates back to the 40s or 50s. Everything I know, there's one exception and I don't mention it because, it's from the 21st century. And it's kind of interesting that basically everything is really old when it comes to these myths. And I think somebody suggested it came because it was widely used in a model kit.
Yeah. Possible, yeah.
So that it got popularized through that, yeah. But yeah.
I mean, that's the point. We have these rules, and the real question is how did it multiply so quickly? And somebody should write a thesis about that.
Yeah, yeah.
The
thing with that hats is gonna hats. Actually, I just realized when we talked before that it's in. I heard it in English several times, and it always sounds correct.
Yeah.
In comparison to all the I think Stuck is also one that's pronounced correctly, yeah. Basically, but it's less. It sounds less German. Yeah. It's the other thing. So yeah.
But again, it's very pop cultural thing, and again, it's a tank destroyer.
I mean, it was a meme before.
Yeah.
With Fuck Life, and then it became Stuck Life, and I think it probably came from War Thunder.
Yeah, but I find it interesting. These cultural aspects of these vehicles are very interesting to me. There need to be more books about that. Somebody should write them.
I mean, you have a new employee with. Erinnerungskultur.
Yeah, but we have to do some things in this museum, so maybe in 5 or 10 years.
Yeah.
So beat us to it.
Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for watching, and see you next time. Bye.